What do you know? That's weird. Automatic. Huh. What do you know? Is this one? This one? Boop. Holy cow. Okay. What do you gotta say? What you doing?
Ball game.
Night night, girls. Get up.
No. Night night.
Where'd Maya's sucker go? I'm afraid to know. Is it all gone?
Did she open her eyes and then her eyes roll back into place?
She went to sleep.
None of your business. Okay, you want one
Would
of
you
these?
Like a mint?
Altoids?
It's 2:15. There she goes. Uh-oh. Oh, she's going up to Jude. That could be bad.
Eighth grade project night.
And you have to take that part.
So
out.
If people could settle in.
Yay!
Get your board and bring it up.
Throw the iron.
project much further than kind of both doing lots of damage. It's a very effective weapon.
The trebuchet was first invented by the Chinese in the 1300s. It traveled the world by the way of nomadic people who moved around the land and gave ideas to other people, sometimes sold them. People like Da Vinci made improvements to the model as it went through where they lived. Like, Da Vinci gave the idea of instead of this type of trebuchet, he made what was called a wolf trebuchet or horse trebuchet. Instead of weight like this, they would have a big kind of barrel almost that would hold rocks and stuff. It was more portable because you could just empty out the rocks and then travel with it. And also, trebuchets were also, wheels were sometimes added in this wood. And instead of a counterweight, which swings gradually, it would just be stationary and wheels would compensate for that. And yeah, there was, the reason trebuchets were invented were to get past castle walls because they were made tougher throughout the years. They eventually had made some defenses, very few though, for trebuchets. One of the main ones was to build trebuchets behind the castle walls so they could take out other trebuchets. Yeah. Wow. And also they would have underground tunnels to lead them around. I had this PowerPoint, but I couldn't get it here, but one of the other defenses was they would have a wheel, like a water wheel, I think, on top, made out of steel and had hooks on the end. So when the object that was being thrown hit it, it'd swing back around in the wheel.
It was very interesting. Not only did they just throw rocks and rubble where they could find on the ground, they would also throw things like flaming balls and whatever matter they could find up. Flammable snakes, poisonous snakes, decapitated heads of soldiers to bring down the morale of the soldiers on the other side. It was very, very interesting, the things that they would throw. It also played a large part in most of the spreading of the company and friends.
Yeah.
But would you like to see basically how the swinging motion of those works?
Yes!
Tennis ball. Come down like so.
Usually what they do, this one, the models of course would be much larger and they would take more than two people, but basically how it worked was you got this back. One of the strings would hook onto a pin-like thing. This would be brought back with the item in there, and when the weight was let loose, the item would be chopped, that the strings usually let go before, so, yeah.
It works a lot better when there's more weight here than just having quite a bit of yes, it's a very effective weapon, and it was largely used throughout the centuries.
More about, I know when you guys were building this, you had a lot of frustrating things happen, but for me, when you get frustrated, you learn stuff. Can you talk more about what didn't work and how you learned as you redid things?
Oh, yeah, it was a very frustrating process. All the tedious little adjustments for the pin up top and the weight. One time we just got so frustrated that we just took a bunch of rocks and parts and stuff and strapped them onto the end.
Because we thought at first of
So, what was the problem?
Well, the problem seems to be is mainly the string length needs to be very precise, along with the pin being hooked. Normally, it's a separate system. If it's already too much, the string won't let loose fast enough, and we'll throw it 2 feet in front of you. But if it's too light, it'll just throw it straight up and then back and on top of you.
And those also, on that video you watched, some of them put wheels on the trebuchets.
Yeah.
What was that about?
I actually looked on the internet. Originally, we had a pole that came down here and just had this weight through a piece of PVC like that, and it was fixed and it didn't do the swinging motion. The swinging motion adds a little, I don't know exactly what it does.
It compensates for the wheel, because when it comes down, the straighter the motion is, when it comes down, I'm not sure how you can see this, but if it starts up here, it comes down straighter than a normal one would. If it was like this, it comes in more of a circular motion, which means that the weight, the object on top would be thrown in a more circular motion or more downward motion. And it comes like
you get a more more centrifugal force coming straight down instead of outwards and around. But the wheels also kind of gave it an extra shove and gave it, instead of a perfect arc, it gave it a more elongated arc. Henry.
Here, we hear, have you ever come across a usage of group fire in the same way of the mountains?
What?
Group fire.
Big fire.
Do you know what that is?
I don't know.
Is it make some chemicals that they use and they light on fire and put it across the walls? And if you pour blood on it, it just got bigger. And so there's no way to put it out. And so you said wait for it to burn out and it would burn out.
Yeah. I've never heard of
it. They probably used it, but
we never came across it.
So, about how far would you estimate that particular thing chucks, whatever it is you're chucking?
About 150 feet. No, 150 feet. The other one we was supposed to throw 100 feet, but we sized all the pieces up by all the factors were upscaled by 1.5 to the original one. We built another one, but we weren't sure.
Our original trebuchet was actually the other version. Yeah, it was actually the other
version with the fixed weight that did not.
And the wheels were. But that didn't work out when we figured that this would be quicker and easier. We wasted enough time on the other one. Most of this pipe is actually.
But this one should throw roughly 150 feet.
But
with the right modification, with the right tweaks in the right places.
Do they currently use trebuchets anywhere? And if not, when did they come out?
Well, they use them a lot.
There was actually an incident. You mean by usage as an actual warfare kind of thing, or just as in
a recreation?
Let's have fun.
Both.
Well, I'm sure that it's used for throwing rocks at the windows or something like that.
You said when did it stop?
Well, yeah, but I know what I was going to ask. How did you guys get interested in it? Where did you hear about it?
Well, Jonathan, I think, kind of turned us on to the idea. It was originally Hunter's idea. I think Hunter was going to do it. I was going to build actually like a motorbike out of the lawn mower and some bike frames and parts I had around. But then I decided me and Hunter would do this together and it would be great. And it turned out to be actually pretty fun. And yeah, Jonathan essentially turned us on to the other student.
So did you find designs and you were talking about some of the fine tuning, you know, in terms of lengths and weights and stream lengths. So it sounds like there weren't resources that gave you like proportional relationships of things, that it's all by trial and error.
But mainly the way there's not a lot of information out there on trebuchets. It's the atomic bomb would be really pretty top secret, and I guess. There's not a lot of information out there on it, but Jonathan, there are plans and conversions over the internet. Because Jonathan had some plans for it because a previous student had tried to build one. And so we had those plans and we scaled those up. We made some adjustments here.
There was also kits that you could buy.
Same way, instead, it would stop right about here and then draw the motion for the object, and that's where the trebuchet steps it up a notch. It uses the constant swinging motion that would be farther down there. It is the swinging weight built up on, but the instant stopping doesn't go quite as easy. Anybody else? Shannon. Physics of motion, and, you know, things like that. Not me.
Talking to me about it, I was like, and apparently it was an accident. He ran through a door and she was behind the door and it hit her in the head. And I was like, and Max, if you hurt Kalminda, you have to say you're sorry and you have to help her go to the office or whatever. Like, if she's hurt, you can't just walk away. And he's like, okay, I'm sorry and I should help you. But it's funny because her dad was watching the whole scenario. And I came back over there to him and I just went, kids. And he goes, I'm really glad you said that to Kalminda. Because she does have a tendency to go way overboard with things.
Just a little bit.
And her mother and I are always telling her that, but the fact that you came right out and said something about not screaming at Max and trying to talk it out and you know, and tell the mom.
Mom, back up. I need backup.
He wants you to back up. I need backup.
Hi, you.
No, he wants
monkey,
you to back up.
Monkey.
He wants you to kill him.
Uh-oh. Oh, I want to hug you and hug you.
That's like how my little
is getting so big.
She just careens. You can tell she's getting tired. She can't really run very well.
We went to the beach yesterday by my house, and Wilde fell asleep as soon as we got home at 8 o'clock. He was just on the couch asleep.
She's just crying. Because it's soft and
cool.
And
if I would have known that Rhiannon was involved, I would have gone with her. But
what? Rhiannon? What?
Rhiannon is running away to California with Sophie right now.
That's so cool.
It's not cool.
Okay, it's not cool, but it's cool that I know. I never knew that they knew each other. That's so cool.
Get this away from me.
Water.
Get
him.
Get
him.
Get him. Get him.
Hey, well,
hi.
Check me when I'm okay with it. What's
it say? He's just attacking anybody.
He's just like, what is going on?
The intercompany video. Where, so, I mean, a boyfriend who lives in New York, he probably isn't going to win it.
Awesome.
He probably isn't going to win. But he might get second. He may win it. Who knows? But, you know, he's such a newbie to it. I imagine there's probably...
Next day. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, I didn't even see.
Hey, Violet, are you wet?
Be the main meal. We can have these and some rice.
Sure.
What are you doing, Violet? What are you doing? Some sunscreen on you, Violet? Violet, what are you doing? You're cleaning? Are you cleaning up the deck?
We need to get some sunscreen on you. Got your sunscreen now, Violet?
Yeah.
What are you doing? That's enough of that. Let's try to keep the water inside the little pool. No. Why not? I want you to dump it out all of it. It'll make it all muddy down there.
No, stop. That's poopy.
What was that? Come over here and tell the camera what you're doing. What are you doing?
I'm cleaning.
You're cleaning? Is it fun? Is it cold?
No, it's hot.
Can you go in? That is gross, Violet. Icky. Don't do that.
I got Human Nature, the Charlie Kaufman movie we haven't seen. Kind of low on the tomato meter.
Stop it, Violet. Put it down. Violet. No. You can't drink the water because it's not clean. Does Mommy need to take it away from you, just like I did the other thing?
Should we put something real bitter in all of our baths? Some sort of bitter? Like they put an antifreeze?
Do you mind not corrupting my video footage with your weird comments? Violet, Mama's gonna have to turn off the camera and come get that little Winnie the Pooh toy. Do I need to do a timeout? Are you in a timeout?
All done.
You're all done? Do you promise you won't drink any more dirty pool water?
No water.
No, it's not clean. If you want some water, I'll get you some clean water.
Clean water?
Yeah. No more drinking pool water, okay?
I'm a bug.
You ready to be done with your timeout? Okay. No more drinking pool water. How come you don't want to sit down in the water?
No.
Why not?
It's all wet.
It's all wet?
No, don't wet.
Why must you do that? What's Phoebe's bowl? Daddy is a foul pig. Too late, honey.
Put 50 cents in. But wait, it's nap time. What you doing?
Awesome.
What? Where's Violet? Hey, there you are.
Oh.
What are you doing? Where'd she go? Hey, I see you. Hey, there's some fingers over there.
No. My finger.
Ah! All right. Night, night. Okay, Phoebe, you can go lay down.
Well, don't say sorry to me. Say sorry to Maya. You have to turn the steering wheel around, you guys. Here, hold on. Good job. Hey, Maya, two babies can't fit in that at the same time, and Violet's having her turn right now. Mama, Maya, Mama. But you had your turn, Maya. Here, come do the tractor. Come do the tractor. Let's see your happy face. Rhodey. Okay, hold on.
Open it. Open it.
No, that doesn't open, honey. Hey, girls, why don't you girls sing You Are My Sunshine? Let's hear it. Can you girls sing Twinkle Little Star? Okay, well, I'm gonna stop recording for a while.
What are you doing, Violet? Do you like pouring the water?
Do you like pouring the water, Violet? Okay.
Yeah.
Is it fun to be up at the sink doing some dishes?
Yeah, it's fun. Doing chips.
Yeah.
Ice. Best ice.
There's a sharp knife over there. Mommy should move it. Mommy will set it over here for now. Oh, careful, it's going to spill on the floor.
Careful.
University till after 9.
Open it now, then. A telegram is serious business.
Mm-hmm. It's from my mother's doctor at the hospital. Please contact me. What's that supposed to mean? Is something wrong with her or not? I know something awful's happened to her. What am I supposed to do if my father's not home?
Listen, you must be calm. Have you any way of telephoning your father?
I have the number of his research lab, but we don't have a telephone to call him.
Take them back to your mother's place and let them use the phone to reach their father. Do you understand? Don't panic, but go quickly.
Mm-hmm.
May, you make sure you're safe. Put it at my house. May! May!
Hey! May, don't follow me! Go to Nanny's house! Hurry. Yes, yes, I'm his daughter.
Whoa, slow down. From the hospital? Oh, okay, it's all right.
I think I understand. Now I'm going to call the hospital.
What's happened, Mommy? Tell me everything's going to be all right.
There's no need to worry. I'm going to check with the hospital and call you right back, okay? Okay?
Uh-huh.
You stay where you are.
Mm-hmm.
I'm hanging up now, so you stay right there.
Don't wake her up.
He'll be calling back, so is it all right if I stay right here by the telephone and wait?
No, don't put your feet on.
All the time you need.
Maya, don't put your feet on Violet. You can give her really gentle kisses.
I know it. Yeah.